originally from Canada. I grew up there and I moved to Nashville about 5 years ago. And my life totally changed once I did, so. This is a song, one of the first ones I wrote when I came to town. It's called Don't Take Me Home.
Thank you. Baytown, Texas, and I come from a very musical family. You might have seen me on The Voice when I was 17 years old. I was on Team Blake, and thank you. That was the start to my country music journey. After The Voice, I moved straight to Nashville, and I've been writing ever since. I moved there when I was 18, and I'm now 20, so I have a lot of songs, but if I sang you all the songs, you would be here for a while. So I'm only gonna sing you a few, and this first song is a song that I wrote. I always felt like when it comes to boys, if I cared a little less, they would care a little more about me. So this song's called Careless, and if you know it, please sing it. Please. Relationship is a 50-50 thing. I don't wanna be the girl always giving in to you. Same old same, it's a daily drain. Waiting on your ring, it's just a losing game. I don't wanna pick up, but then I pick up. I don't wanna give up, should I give up? It's just a chase, a Tom and Jerry race. Will it ever change? I bet if I turn this heart off, baby, it would turn you on. I bet if I blocked you, you'd be blowing up my best friend's phone. I bet you'd be on your knees on that floor if I stuck and lost, if I swam that door. Maybe if I care less, maybe if I care less, you would care a little more. If I had a hand that didn't wanna ring, you wouldn't be cool with the final fling. Yeah, what we have is just a rush, yeah, just a touch, but not enough. I lend my heart and then you wig out. I gave my all to you, but if I said see you just like that, would you be back on looking sad, yeah, trying to last? I bet if I turned this heart off, baby, it would turn you on. I bet if I blocked you, you'd be blowing up my best friend's phone. I bet you'd be on your knees on that floor if I stayed and lost, if I swam that door. Maybe if I care less, maybe if I care less, you would care a little more.
December, when we were 15 and 16, and decided to start singing together and writing songs, and it's been just this incredible journey together, and soul sisters, I guess.
But yeah, so we met 4 years ago, and since then we probably have a collection of over, what, 200 songs?
Mm-hmm. I think we all have that same thing in common.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we write a lot. But yes. This first song we want to play for you is called Boomerang, and it's really fun, so hope you like it.
Yeah.
Maybe you're forgetting that you're the one who called it quits. Say your story, I already know the end. Well, I should've known that you'd come crawling back. only thing to do when you lose the best thing you ever had. Shot from a goodbye gun, bro, that only runs one way. Anything but a boomerang. Now you're second guessing, what do you expect from me? Pick up where we left off, go back to what we used to be.
Single on the radio for the very first time was just such a memorable moment, and I remember I was in Phoenix. I think we were in the middle of a radio tour, and they were like, "Have you heard your song for the first time on the radio?" And I'm like, "No, I haven't yet. You know, I'm still waiting for that moment." And they're like, "Well, we're gonna change this." So we were eating dinner, and we ended up walking out of the restaurant and flagging a cab down. And we were like, "Hey, sir," and we sort of explained the situation, and he was like, "Would you mind if we called the station and we wait till her song comes on the air?" And he's like, yeah, no problem. And so we're waiting, and we probably waited about 15 minutes, and he's just sort of standing there, and we're all having fun. And finally my song gets on, and I'm going crazy. I'm dancing, I'm jumping in and out of the car, I'm high-fiving and hugging everybody, and he's in it. Like, he's high-fiving me, and he's like all in it. And then I realized that the meter had been running the whole time. So he's probably like, "We can do this all night, this is great." This is my first single to the country radio ever. This is called Trippin' On Us.
Crazy.
From talking to my mama, and I was talking to her one day, and when you think about Texas woman, she's all of that and more. She's the higher the hair, the closer to God, an out of control personality, and I'm just like her. And I was talking to her one day, and I was boohooing about not having a boyfriend that day, and I was like, Mama, I just don't get it. I think I'm extremely funny, I am blonde, and I can sing a boy a country song. Like, what more does he need? And she was like, honey, you do not need to worry about boys right now. You were just having fun and kissing frogs. Like, that's just not what you need to worry about. And I was like, holy Jehovah, that has got to be a song. So the next day, I went into the studio, and I was with these two guys, and I was like, hey, I know y'all are dudes, but we're going to write a song about having fun and kissing lots of boys. So I know I'm not the only girl that's kissed a lot of boys this summer and had fun, so this is a song called Kissing Frogs. Hope you like it. I'm too young to think about forever. I'm just thinking about this Friday night. I love not knowing where we're going and dancing with the boy I kinda like. I wanna make all of my mistakes while I'm young enough to make them once or twice, maybe three times. Cause I ain't looking for my Prince Charming, not a horse, no once upon a time and women. Yeah, I don't need a mister trying to fit that perfect slipper on my foot. There's always time for that. Here we go, so I'm gonna spend all summer long sitting on this river long. Cause right now there ain't nothing wrong with having fun and kissing for all. Right now the only thing that matters is the radio and cherry lip gloss song. I'm happy without happy ever after. Yeah, little making out don't hurt no one. I wanna have a little fun. Someday I'm gonna find the one that's right, but not tonight. Hey! Cause I ain't looking for my place. Who's the once upon a time and women? No, yeah, I don't need a mister trying to fit that perfect slipper on my foot. There's always time for that. So I'm gonna spend all summer long sitting on this river
'cause right now there ain't nothing wrong with having fun and kissing for wrong. Once or twice, maybe three times. Hey, 'cause I ain't looking for my prince charming, not a horse gone once upon a time in women. Yeah, I don't need a mister trying to fit that perfect slipper on my foot. There's always time for that. So I'm gonna spend all summer long sitting on this river low, 'cause right now with having fun and kissing frogs. Yeah, I'm gonna spend all summer long sitting on this river low, 'cause right now there ain't nothing wrong with having fun and kissing frogs. Ribbit.
But so like I said, Maddie and I have written a ton of songs, and I mean, we're both 19, so we're right in the midst of all that drama. Why not put it into a song?
Oh, yeah.
But I think we all can agree that sometimes love is hard when it seems like you're always wanting what you can't have. And I know I've definitely felt that way, so that's why we wrote this next song, and it's called Smoke.
Burned you so bad, left your heart in ashes on the ground. Made you promises, took them right back, left you cold and alone. Now all you know is the sound of goodbye. You won't let anyone inside. Baby, you're just like smoke blowing on the wind, warming here by my side. And then you're gone again. You start out slow like an ember, get the fire burning back behind your eyes. I wanna feel you when we're together, so whatever you do, baby, don't disappear this time.
Thank you. ready, and then we'll bring the band back together. But we'll do this just a cappella. Here we go, Schmitty.
One, two. The way you're making me feel.
Love it.
Really turn me on. Sing it. You knock me off of my feet. My lonely days are gone. Keep it going. The way you're making me feel. You really turn me on. You knock me off of my feet. My lonely days are gone.
Last Tuesday, and I did mine Friday, and isn't it the coolest feeling ever? Yeah, congratulations to you too. Oh my God. And I got to sing this song on the Grand Ole Opry, and it was such a moment. And I've never gotten chills when I sang this song, but right when I sang it, I literally had chills all over my body. And my favorite thing about country music is the stories that we can tell, and how real we can be with our fans. And it's just, it's really amazing. And when I wanted to write this song, I was really nervous and I thought it would be too heavy. But, you know, I got to thinking about it and I was like, no, this is me. This is a part of me. This is something that I went through. And I know that there are fans out there that went through the same thing. And so I wrote this song about my parents getting a divorce when I was 3. And that was really hard on me growing up because I was always that kid stuck in the middle, relaying information back and forth. And when you're growing up, that's really unfair. And anyways, like I said, I moved to Nashville at 18 and I was writing Monday through Friday. And I was headed to a writing session and my mom and dad were blowing me up, just arguing over the stupidest thing. And I almost canceled my write, but I decided to go, and I'm so glad that I decided to go because I would have never written this song. And it's it means a lot to me and it's so cool. I've gotten like, I have like 10 letters at home from fans that they've sent me that this song has impacted, and this song just means a lot to me, and it's called Love Triangle. So I hope you like it.
Sitting on the front step, little white suitcase, hearing that diesel before it hit the front gate. His headlights burning down a Friday night. Southern Belle statue standing in the screen door, watching her whole world head for an old Ford with a man that can't look her in the eye. So I'll write to him, big hug, jump in, and I cry for her out the window, yeah. Some mamas and daddies are loving in a straight line, take forever to heart and then take a long sway ride. But some mamas and daddies let their heartstrings tear and and some of us get stuck in a love triangle. Bowling alley burger, fries and a milkshake, headed to the same old $2 matinee. Baby, how's your school been and how's your mom? Fancy clown echoes back off the dashboard, staring at my boots and the dusty old floorboard. Baby, 2 weeks ain't really all that long.
I'll write to her, wrap my arms around her skirt, and I'll cry for him out the window.
So Tay and I are 19 years old, and we graduated high school about a year and a half ago, and moved up to Nashville 5 days after. We were like, peace out, y'all, we're out of here. So in high school, back home in Texas, I had this girl named Sierra, and she was basically this beauty queen bully, if y'all can imagine, this beautiful girl that was so mean. Her and all her friends would say, oh, Maddie Marlowe's not pretty enough, she's not good enough, she'll never make it, all this. So finally, before I graduated, and she bullied just about any girl or guy in school, and so finally, I told Tay about this girl, and I was like, you know what, before I graduate, we need to write a song about this. We need to put this in a song. So I guess you could say this next one's pretty brutally honest, but this is for anyone that had someone that told them they couldn't do something. So this is called Sierra. One, two, three, four.
I had something nice to say about that girl and her $1 million face. But beauty only gets you so far. Amen. A heart of pure gold is something very rare, and the only one she has is on that necklace that she wears. Acts like she's some kind of movie star. Ooh, it might not be Christian to be wishing what I'm wishing. Sierra, Sierra, girl, let me tell ya, one day you might need those friends that you ditched. Sierra, Sierra, life ain't all tiaras. You're gonna find out that karma's a two-tick. Even that, cause I know the universe is gonna get you back. All I have to do is bide my time. Ooh, I hope that I'm around when you get knocked up or get knocked down. Sierra, Sierra, girl, let me tell ya, you can't break boys' hearts like you.
you're flipping a switch. Sierra, life ain't all Tierras. You're gonna find out that karma's a big pain in the end. As far as I can tell, yours is an ineffective Sierra. Sierra, Sierra, girl, let me tell you, that high horse you're riding can fuck you off quick.
Scoop, right? So I sent it to like two of the other girls that she bullied really bad. One of them transferred schools because she was bullied so bad. Yeah, it was bad. So I sent it to them and I was like, don't send this to anyone. This is just for closure for us to graduate and feel like we finally said something. Well, you know, high school word spreads, so the song just goes all around my high school and I'm like, crap, I'm graduating in 2 weeks and I still have to see this girl in the hallways.
I would have just sang it for her.
I know. Well, see, my dad told me to just, like, go boom, and I was like, well, I think we did that with a song, you know? No physical violence, you know? So I was walking down the hallway, and I was kind of just like, you know, I really don't want to see anyone, because some people would be like, oh, my gosh, it's so awesome, and some people, like her friends, would be like, I hate you, and I was like, okay. So anyways, I'm walking down the hallway, mind my own business, and the principal comes up to me, and I'm about to get expelled from school. Like, I'm screwed. My diploma's gonna be taken from me. And she's like, so legally, I can't have that song right now, but when you graduate, will you send it to me? And I was like, yes, ma'am.
So that explains everything.
Yeah.
A good friend of mine back home has something called muscular dystrophy, but she has one of the most beautiful hearts I've ever met in my life. And she came to me one day and said, Lindsay, my boyfriend just broke up with me. He told me he couldn't take it anymore. And I didn't know what to tell her. She was so heartbroken. And eventually I was like, well, you know what? One day that boy's gonna realize what he let go. And he's gonna realize that there's not another you out there. So I wrote her this song. This is called Not Another Me.
The greener grass on on the other side. So go on and try. Search low and high.
So many different women is because there were so many different women that were in the writing session. I'm 20. The girl named Nicole Gallion who wrote on it is 30. And then Lori McKenna is in her 40s. And Liz Rose, who's written everything Taylor Swift, is in her 50s. And anyways, we all got in a room together. And you get four girls who like to vent about boys in a room together. You're going to write a song called God Made Girls. And we wrote this song in an hour and a half, like literally so fast. And right when I sent it over to my label, it instantly became my first single. And if you know it, please sing along. And if you haven't downloaded it yet, I'm going to come get you after this. So this is God Made Girls.
Somebody's gotta wear a pretty skirt. Somebody's gotta be the one to flirt. Somebody's gotta wanna hold his hands. To God made girls. Somebody's gotta make him get dressed up. Give him a reason to wash that truck. Somebody's gotta teach him how to dance. To God made girls. He needed something soft and loud and sweet and proud, but tough enough to break a heart. Something beautiful, unbreakable, that lights up in the dark. So God made girls, God made girls. He stood back and told the boys, I'm about to rock your world. Then God made girls. Told the girls I'm about to rock your world. Then God made girls.
I see y'all singing it. Hey.
Somebody's gotta be the one to cry. Somebody's gotta let him drive. Give him a reason to hold that door. So God made girls. Yeah. Somebody's gotta pull. put back. Make him wait on our side, ain't that? To walk downstairs and blow his mind. So God made girls, something that can wake him up and call his bluff and drag his butt to church. Something that is hard to handle, something fragile to hold him when he hurts. So God made girls, God made girls. He stood back and told the boys, I'm about to rock your world. Then God made for singing and your practicing, for dancing to the wrong beat. He stood back and told the boys, I'm about to rock your world. Then God made girls, yeah, yeah, yeah. How many girls we got out there? Somebody's gotta wear a pretty skirt. Somebody's gotta be the one to flirt. Somebody's gotta wanna hold his hand. So God made girls, God made told them who's about to rock your world. Then God made somebody's gotta wear a pretty skirt. Somebody's gotta be the one to flirt. Somebody's gotta wanna hold his hand. So God made girls.
Thank you. As songwriters, all of us, as I said, we put our stories into songs, and it's funny to see, you know, what you're inspired by and what you want to write about. And so this next one is called After the Storm Blows Through. And one of my good friends, thank you, one of my good friends back home in Texas, she lost her dad unexpectedly. And being 18 and having to go through something like that, we can't even fathom how that must feel. And so we wrote this next one really for anyone that needs to hear it.
Been walking around with a dark cloud hanging over every step you take. Like the slightest breeze will knock you to your knees, doing your best not to break. Wish I had the words to tell you, but I got an umbrella and I think it's big enough for the both of us. I'll face that way. If it take on that rain, I don't mind, or give you space, or give you time if you need me to. But I'll be here for you after the storm blows through. The weather and that ain't gonna change. I don't know how long the hurt will hold on or when the sun will shine again. So until then, I'll face that wind by your side. If it take on that rain, I don't mind, or give you space, or give you time if you need me to. But I'll be here for you after the storm blows through. And your skies are blue again, and you're back to you again, my. your side. Even take on that rain, I don't mind. Or give you space, or give you time if you need me to. But I'll be here for you after the storm blows through.
For checking it out on iTunes.
Awesome.
Being a guitar player and coming to Nashville was a huge thing for me to discover, to try to find, put those two pieces together and be a female on country radio to boot. So it's kind of been a search and discovery to find songs to mold everything together. But I'm really excited about this one. This kind of brings out the girl power that I think Shania did so well a few years back. So thanks again, everybody. My name is Lindsay L. This is Shut Me Up.
Can't shut me up.
I got set up to write with this girl, and they told me that she was a pop writer, and that she was my age, and that she was really cool, and that we would probably write a really awesome song together. And I was like all excited about it. And so anyways, I go into the writing session, and I meet this girl, and she is so awesome. We start showing each other songs, and she, first of all, she has the most amazing voice, like just amazing voice. And anyway, she shows me this song, and she's like, "Ray, I've been playing this song for everybody, and nobody wants to cut it, and I don't know why anybody wants to cut it. I think it's really great." And so she plays me this song, and I was like, "Megan, this song is going to be huge. Like, you realize that this song is going to be huge, right?" I was like, "You need to sing this song." And she goes, "Ray, I don't have a record deal. Like, you know, I just want to be a songwriter in Nashville. Like, I mean, I just want to be a songwriter. I don't want to be an artist." And I said, "No, Megan, you are a star. You are a star, and you have to do this song." Well, a year later, she texts me, and she's like, "Hey, girl, we got to go do something. I just got signed by L.A. Reid." And I was like, "What? Oh, my God, that's amazing." So we hung out, and it was really cool. And then a year later, so this was 2 years ago, she showed me this song. So now she has the number one song on Billboard and iTunes, and her song is all about that bass. Megan Trainor. Yes, I mean, like, out of control. She's still the sweetest person you'll ever meet in your life. And I just think it's crazy, like, because everybody's like, "Oh my God, that all about that bass song." I was like, "I knew that girl when, you know, like, I could actually say that. I've never been able to say that. I could say that." Anyway, so cool. Well, this is my version of All About That Bass. And I know all you girls are out there got some bass, and you want to sing this song with me, so I need y'all all to sing it out with me. Will y'all sing it out with me? I need it a little louder. Okay. Alright, it's a little different. This is the Ray version, country version, twangy version. So this is All About That Bass. Come on, Lindsay, you just do whatever you do because you're amazing. Because you know I'm all about that bass, no treble. I'm all about that bass, no treble. I'm all about that bass, yeah. I'm all about that bass. Yeah, it's pretty clear, I ain't no size two, but I can shake it, shake it like I'm supposed to do. Cause I got that boom, boom, that all them boys chasing all the right junk in all the right places. I see the magazines working that Photoshop. We know that ain't real, come on, let's make it stop. If you got beauty, beauty, then let it show. Cause every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top. Yeah, my mama, she told me don't worry about your size, no. She says, "Boys like a little more booty to hold at night. That booty, booty, all that booty. And I won't be no stick for you, silly. Come by me down, no. Oh, so if that's what you're into, then go ahead and move along. Yay, sing with me. Because you know I'm all about that bass, no treble. About that bass, no treble. I'm all about that bass, yeah. I'm all about that bass." I'm bringing booty back. That's right. Go ahead and tell them skinny girls that. No, I'm just playing. I know y'all think you fair, yeah. But I'm here to tell you every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top. Yeah, my mama, she told me no. I'm all about that bass, no treble. I'm all about that bass, no treble. I'm all about that bass, ow!
this bass. You know you got some bass. Yeah. Oh, every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top. Hey.
But gosh, you know, sometimes when we're listening to country radio, some of the lyrics and some of these songs that are out right now make us women seem like an object, or Maddie and I like to call it arm candy. And so Maddie and I wanted to write a song that showed a completely different side to this lady that these guys just seem to love writing and singing about. And so we made a checklist, literally, guys, a checklist of all the cliches that are in these songs. And what it had, like, bare feet, cutoffs, trucks,
tailgates,
sugar shaker,
money maker.
I don't, Ray, what is a sugar shaker? Will you tell me what that is?
Is it that base?
Is it a base? It probably has something to do with base.
I think it has to do something with your base. Yeah.
But I don't even know. But the most important one of all is the girl.
Yes, there's always this smoking hot girl that these guys sing about, which is fine. But to be the smoking hot girl in a country song, you have to have long tan legs, dancing barefoot on a tailgate, cut off jeans. And let me tell y'all, God did not bless all of us with long tan legs. I am 5'2". So Tay and I had so much fun writing this song, just bringing the girl's perspective to light and how hard it is to be this perfect Barbie doll girl all the time. So we wrote this next one. If y'all know it, sing along. It's called Girl in a Country Song. Has a mind of his own. Well, I wish I had some shoes on my two bare feet. And it's getting kind of cold, and he's painted on cut off jeans. I hate the way this bikini top chafes. Do I really have to wear it all day? Yeah, baby. I hear you over there on your tailgate whistling, saying, hey girl, but you know I ain't listening. Cause I got a name, and to you it ain't pretty little thing. Howdy, old baby, yeah, it's driving me red, 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 crazy. Being the girl in the country song. Good for is looking good for you and your friends on the weekend, nothing more. We used to get a little respect, now we're lucky if we even get to climb up in your truck, keep our mouth shut and ride along, and be the girl in a country song. Well, shaking my money maker, I ain't never made me a dime. And there ain't no sugar for you in this sugar of mine. And tell me one more time, you gotta get you some of that. Sure, I'll slide on over, but you're gonna get slapped. These days it ain't easy being man. Girl in a country song. How in the world did it go so wrong? Like our good food is looking good for you and your friends on the weekend. Nothing more. In your truck, keep our mouth shut and ride along, and be the girl in a country song. Yeah, 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 baby, y'all sound so good out there. Oh no, come on, you do it straight.